Hi, YouTube family. Today I want to talk about this family, the Watts family, that's been on the news. Chris Watts here murdered his wife and his two daughters, and his wife was pregnant at the time, 15 weeks pregnant with their son. And I want to talk about this because just observing what's been going on in the news, what's being uncovered and shown about this family, especially about Chris Watts, reflects a lot of narcissistic tendencies. And I want to point this out so that you can see and hear what that would look like in this case. I do want to start with something about him having an affair, though. It's coming out that he had an affair, and I'm not entirely sure if this is accurate, but if it is, it does explain a lot of what happened. So what happened here is when a person has an affair, there are things that happen inside of their brain. There are hormones that are released, several, but two of the main ones are oxytocin and dopamine. Oxytocin is a hormone that encourages or releases a feeling of love and trust, and it lowers our defenses and makes us trust people more. It's also a bonding hormone. It helps us to bond with other people when this is released. And what happens during sexual activity is oxytocin is released inside of a person. Now, there's also dopamine. Dopamine is another hormone, and what happens there is pleasure is released. It's the pleasure hormone. When there's a surge of dopamine, it creates a feeling of addiction. So when a person is having an affair and they're sexual with their lover, obviously, they then would release these hormones, which causes their brain to trust, love, bond, and become addicted to that person. And not only that, but you also develop infatuation for that person because of all these hormones that are coming up in your brain. Now, this infatuation period is a really terrible time to make any decisions, any lifelong, life-affecting decisions, such as engagement, marriage, buying a house together, having children, any of that. So here he is, he's having an affair, and what I'm seeing or, you know, figuring out is that his hormones are going crazy, and also when you're sexually aroused, there's a region of your brain that turns off, that regulates critical thinking and self-awareness and your rational behavior. And when that happens, you're really extremely irrational. So your brain is caught in a contradiction where you're married, but you also have a lover, and it has to reconcile somewhere in there how these two worlds can exist, and either you detach from one or the other. And in his case, it looks like he was detaching from his wife. We don't know how long the affair was going on. But also what happens in an affair, in a sexual affair, is that when these hormones are being released, you tend to gravitate more towards what's helping you release those hormones. So his mistress, he's going to gravitate towards her more and detach more and more from his family, from his wife, from his children. And then ultimately, during this infatuation period too with the mistress, he's not thinking straight. He's not, his critical thinking is shutting down or being suppressed. And during that period, a person's mind tends to think very irrationally, very reactively, and it makes no sense, but you are desperately wanting to save this fantasy and hold on to it. The fantasy that created this world of swirling hormones that has brought you incredible pleasure, incredible bonding, this infatuation world where everything is just perfect and heightened. It could cause you to do things you would not do in a normal, rational state. And here's a picture of him, actually. displaying somewhat of a narcissistic response. He was, in this picture, he was talking to a news crew and into the camera, pleading for his wife and his daughters to return home. And look at him. He's got his arms crossed like, you know, I'm hiding something. I'm not going to let you know. But he's also smiling. And in I don't want to call it an interview. I don't know what it is. But in front of the camera, he's pleading for his children to come home and his wife to come home. But he's chuckling, smiling, almost like trying to charm the camera, which is bizarre. Because if he were truly upset about his wife and didn't know where his wife and his daughters were, he'd be crying into the camera, please, and begging whoever to bring them back. But he knows no one's bringing them back. He knows where they are, and he's hiding it from us. He thinks he's fooling us. It's very narcissistic. He knows all of this, but his body betrays him. So he thinks he's fooling us. His body's going to betray him with smiling and with this dance where he's holding his arms tightly together, showing that he has something to hide. And if he were truly not a narcissist, he would be remorseful. He would be showing some kind of guilt at this point. He would be seeing emotions of guilt and remorse, which he could camouflage as, you know, sadness and grief. But he can't even muster the emotion of remorse and guilt to make it look like he's sad and upset. So, it's so horrible, this whole thing. He also said that he saw his wife strangling one of their children, and that's when he lost his temper and went crazy or whatever, and then strangled his wife. Saying that his wife killed their two kids. But if this were true, then he wouldn't have disposed of their bodies the way he did. He buried his wife, but then his children, if his story were true about seeing his wife hurting his children, he would then want to protect them, or at least feel, you know, a sense of incredible loss, and treated their bodies with respect. But instead, he dumped his two daughters' bodies into an oil well and did not even give them somewhat of a burial, a blessing, something of a goodbye, you know, that a person who loved their children would have given. Now, I'm not quite sure why he did all of this, and everybody had said, you know, that it seemed like they were a happy family and they were doing really well. But whatever drove him to do this, the way he has reacted has been very narcissistic. Seems that he is only, he has no remorse. He has no guilt. He lied bold-faced to the camera, holding his arms together, smiling. It's bizarre. You see that he doesn't even have feelings of loss. You don't even see that coming out of him. So, you know, a narcissist can, during a relationship, behave as if they love and care about their subject, okay, their supply. They can act like, I love you, and they're very attentive, and they can be even considerate. They can be very affectionate, but deep down, they have no real attachment to that person. And then it gets even worse when you introduce a third person, a mistress, where now you're bringing up all these hormones in a sexual affair, and your mind cannot separate or reconcile being married and now being attached to another person. So you're going to try to end the marriage, or at least one of these two relationships. And we saw what happened here, which is extremely sad. I just want to tell you that if you notice that, or you're feeling that your spouse is cheating on you or something like that, don't get jealous of the other person. You need to deal with the spouse. Something's going on there. You need to deal with the spouse and find out what is going on in their mind, because it's happening in the spouse's mind. The change is happening there. The hormonal imbalances and craziness and explosions are happening there. So you have to bring out the truth. You have to talk through the feelings. You have to expose what's going on inside of the spouse. And in most marriages, this can be reconciled. This can be fixed. But not if you're going to be focused on the third party and blaming them and getting jealous of them and pulling them into it. Just leave them out and deal with your spouse. I'm not saying that this is what Shanann, the wife, had done here. I'm just saying that if it happens in your relationship, that you have to work it out with your spouse. So, YouTube family, I hope that that has helped, and I pray blessings over this mom and her kids. I hope that they are resting in heaven and that their families, her parents, their relatives will find peace.